He said, seeing when Bhagavan says Kshetrajna Chapi Mam Vidhi, the difficulty is this. Oh, everybody is only one, that is Ishvara, if you say, then if you take he is asamsari, then there is no samsara at all. Then what is there to fight? Bandha, moksha, shastra, there is no meaning. Or, if you take from this side, I am samsari, everybody is a samsari. Therefore, Kshatrajna is himself Ishvara. Therefore, Ishvara is also a samsari. Either take it from that direction or from this direction. That is also meaningless. Okay, because who has to improve Ishvara if he is suffering from avidya, samsara? Okay, therefore, it's a bundle of mistakes. It's some very confusing. No, it's not like that. Bhagavan does not speak senseless things. So the situation is this. There are two states. Okay. Avidya state and vidya state. In avidya state, everything works. That is, you don't know that you are Ishvara. Therefore, you are having samsara and all that. Therefore, everything bandha, moksha is there. Don't think it is not there. It is there. But the moment you come to know that you are Ishvara, you are no longer a samsari. Therefore, dhuramete viparite vishuchi, it was told. That is, vidya and avidya are entirely two different things. Remember all that was told? Therefore, if you consider that they are two different, in other words, for a given person, the two things are separated by time, before knowing and after knowing. Okay, before knowing there is samsara, afterwards there is no samsara. Therefore, there is no contradiction here. Okay, then it was told, what is samsara? You say, you are mistaking yourself as the body. You are mistaking yourself as the body. That you are mistaking yourself from the body, everybody is agreeing. Who? Sankhya, Vaisheshika, Buddha, Tarkika, everybody agrees. Only Nastikas won't agree. See, even Christians and Muslims, they say, after you die, your death, you go to heavens or something. That is, you are there afterwards. Therefore, if you think that you are the body now, that is wrong. Everybody will accept. Okay. Therefore, just as you are mistaking a rope for a serpent or a stump for a thief, now you are mistaking yourself for the body. Okay, that is wrong. That is the root of all samsara. Then he says your example is very wrong. Because both stump and thief are jnaya for you. Both serpent and rope. But here, one is jnata and the other is jnaya. So, there is something illogical. It is not proper. Say, no, it is not like that. Because, see, if you tell that, the point Bhashyakara told is this. You are agreeing that you are different from the body? Okay. Therefore, even the body dies, you are not dying. If the body becomes old, you are not becoming old. You agree. But now you say, sukha, dukkha, I experience through the body. Sukha, dukkha, I am experiencing through the body. Now, when through the body I am experiencing, I am taking it for granted that I am the body. Is it all right or not? See, it's very cold. So if I cover the body, Yeah. Then what happens is, the heat is protected in the body, so I don't feel cold. So, now see, sentence itself. The body is covered, the heat is protected, so I feel that I am all right, warm. Are you saying this? That is, actually what is happening, sukha dukkha, is only for the body. But you are telling the effect is mine. Therefore, once again you are only in that. So, you are mistaking, though you are jnata, you are mistaking yourself for the jnaya. That is the mistake you are doing. Okay. Moreover, in Brahma Sutra Bhashya, he has made it clear. When you say Kshetrajna, this Kshetrajna is Asmat Pratyaya Gochara. Asmat Pratyaya Gochara means, for you, Kshetrajna is Jnaya. Following or not? So this is also Jnaya. Sharira is also Jnaya for you. Therefore, it is only between these two jnayas that you are doing. You can do. Did you follow? Therefore, there is nothing wrong in our statements. There. Now, next thing. So, he asks, avidyavatvat kshetrajnasya samsarittvam iti chet? Na. Avidyavatvat. See, Kshetrajna is with avidya. Kshetrajna is with avidya. You are yourself telling. You have to understand you are Kshetrajna. No, you are just now, you are now having avidya. No, later you don't have avidya. Are you telling or not? Therefore, now I am having avidya. There is samsara. It is due to samsara. Therefore, the fault is once again of Kshetrajna only. How can you become Ishvara? Followed or not? See, are you not telling? He is asking the Guru. You are telling. See, you have to understand. Now, before understanding, you feel. You are having samsara. Afterwards, you don't feel. Therefore, you means who? I am Kshetrajna. Therefore, I am having avidya. Afterwards, I will give up avidya. Okay. If I am having avidya now, it means that is due to samsara. That is leading to samsara. So I am samsari. The very fact that I am having avidya proves that I am samsari. So how can I become Ishvara? Are you following? Is it clear or not? Say, no. Is gradually separating. This is a very, very profound section. You will see, for another 3-4 days, it will happen like this. What happens is, see, understand properly avidya, what avidya is. You are telling it is mine, it is mine, it is mine, you are telling it. Whether it is yours or not, you go on seeing it carefully, you see it. What is the result of avidya? You don't know. Or you have confusion. Or you are mistaken. These are the three effects of ignorance. What is it? Agrahana, I don't know. Samshya, I am doubtful. Viparita, I know wrongly. These are the effects. Is it not so? No. Not knowing is tamasohi pratyaya. Tamasohi pratyaya means what? It is, I am not knowing it. I am not able to say it because there is no light. That's all. Therefore, the truth has been covered by your ignorance. Truth is there. It has been covered by ignorance. Therefore, that it is covered by ignorance, you are seeing it. Clearly you are seeing it. For instance, take an example. What is the example? No, I am not able to say something. If I am not able to say something, then I bring the light. Okay. And when the light, I say, I'm all right, I will say. So what does it mean? It means that there was no prakasha, therefore you did not see. When does it happen? No, another thing. Suppose there is pitch darkness. You are taken to a new place where there is pitch darkness. You can't say whether there is anything or there is nothing. You can't say. When can you say, there is something I am not able to see properly? When do you say that? Only there is mandandakara. There is only a little light. Are you following? Similarly, there is a little light here also. What is the little light here? I know of my existence. Remember where? Where?
Sushupti.
Where do you know? In Sushupti. Therefore, I know my existence. I have a little light.
Sadharan gyan
hai. Huh?
Sadharan gyan hai.
Sadharan gyan. Samanya gyan.
Samanya
gyan. No, I have got that samanya gyan. Only I don't have a clear knowledge. Okay. Therefore, if you are having samanya jnana, it means if you don't have a clear jnana, you have to discuss it, know it. That is all. How can you say it is your dharma? It is, you want only prakasha, some light.
Yes.
Therefore, analyze it properly. That is all. What is the prakasha? The prakasha is coming from shastra. See, analyze it. See, he is taking you very slowly. In the last section, he will take you to the climax. And then you must be clear. That is, he is gradually removing. Therefore, he says, Tamaso hi pratya avranatmakatvat avidya viparita graha samshopasthapaka agranatmakova. There are three only. How do you say? Vikaya viveka prakasha bhava tadabhavat. Prakash bhave tadabhavat. Oh, the moment there is viveka, there is prakasha, then it won't be there. What won't be there? Not knowing, or knowing in a confused way, or knowing in a wrong way. All these things happen only in the absence of viveka. In the absence of proper analysis.
ठीक
है right. This tamasa is only darkness. Tamas is andhakara. Okay. So tamasa hi prati. Tamasa cha avaranatmike timrat doshe sati agrahana deha avidya tarisu upalabdhe. All these three aspects you can see only when there is darkness. Okay. There he is. Atra. Hari, again and again you are telling. Only you have to know, you have to know, you have to know, you are telling. Therefore, atra. Yantari, jnatra dharma avidya. Once again he is coming back, see. Are you not telling me? Only do viveka. Bring prakasha. Then you will be able to understand. Say, it means that I am having avidya now. I am having it now, already. Therefore, I am tari jnata dharma avidya. Jnata, the knower's fault. It's the knower's fault. Only he has to discuss it. See, you go on following simply sentences. He will throw light on it at the end. If I can tell it even now, it becomes very easy for you to understand. I think that is better. Because he wants to exhaust all the questions. If I tell the final answer, okay, all the questions will be answered immediately. But when somebody asks a question, you won't be able to answer.
Swami, so what discussion karte hain?
Swami ji, one thing is there. Supposing there is total darkness, still we are able to know an object exists by other means.
True. No, but that is, you should not take that situation here.
Okay.
You are telling only one situation here.
Okay.
That I am not able to see. Only you are telling that. Okay. So now, oh, atra jnanadhrutam avidya iti na. Okay. Yes? Because karane chakshita imirikitva di dosho balabdhe. Because where is the fault? In the absence of prakasha, if you are not able to see clearly. See. अत्र एवं तरी ज्ञातधर्म अविद्या therefore it is only ज्ञातो धर्म the knower's धर्म that's what he is making comment Bhashyakara na because karane chakshushi taimirikatvadi doshopalabdhe because when I am talking of prakasha what does it mean the dosha is in the eye if you bring prakasha it will be all right when does prakasha help you taking it for granted that the eye is all right is it not so when the eye is all right when the prakasha comes you will be able to see clearly to that extent I am giving the example this prakasha what you need is prakasha so examine the pramana properly understand it okay so the dosha is only in the karana what is the karana in this example the karana is the eye okay so he says but you are telling Bhashyakara is telling him yattu manyase jnatra dharma vidya tadevacha vidya dharmavattam kshetrajna samsaritvam yattra yuktam ishvariya kshetrajna samsariti etad ayuktam you are telling so much what are you telling yattu manyase jnatra dharma vidya oh jnatra dharma vidya तदेव च विद्याधर्मत्वं क्षेत्रज्ञस्य ओ क्षेत्रज्ञस्य दोष इज ओनली दैट अविद्याधर्मत्वं दैट ही इज विथ अविद्या देयरफॉर व्हेन ही इज हैविंग अविद्या हाउ कैन ही से ही इज ईश्वर एंड नॉट संसारी ही इज हैविंग इट यू आर योरसेल्फ टेलिंग इट आई एम नॉट टेलिंग इट ओके therefore how can you say is asamsari ishvara whatever you are telling eta dayuktam iti therefore it's not correct you are telling tanna that's not so see once again he is again and again telling jnatru 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 dharma is avidya jnatru dharma is avidya that is is the dharma of kshetrajna kshetrajna therefore kshetrajna is bhagavan we can't accept it okay but what Bhashyakara is trying to tell means no it is only karana dharma it is only of the eye or of the mind or whatever it is like this it is not of kshetrajna that's why he is pushing understand once again the argument he is telling it is jnatra dharma Shankaracharya is saying, it is not Jnatra Dharma, it is Jnaya Dharma. Now, how can he say Jnaya Dharma? See, whenever you see, when you are bringing Prakasha and you have got a clear knowledge, it means in the absence of Prakasha, you did not see. Okay, therefore it had to help, the eyes had to be helped, bring some Prakasha. Similarly, here also bring some Prakasha. Through the Shastra. Make proper discussion. Okay. So, Bhashyakara is trying to convince him gradually that the fault is in the Jnaya itself, not in Jnata. Okay?
मतलब स्वामी करण में फॉल्ट बता रहे हैं तो मतलब वो करण गे है इसलिए गे में फॉल्ट आ भी कहना चाह रहे हैं
हां द फॉल्ट इज इन करण हां
करण में फॉल्ट है
यस हां सी व्हाट इज द करण नाउ ही हैज टॉक्ड ऑफ प्रकाश व्हिच इज नॉट एनी बट दैट इज आल्सो करण प्रमा करण दैट प्रोड्यूसेस सिमिलरली हियर आल्सो ही कैन कम लिटिल अर्ली प्रीवियस टू दैट स्टेज आल्सो वी विल डिस्कस ही ग्रेजुअली हाउ करणे चक्षुषे विपरीत ग्रहण दोष से दर्शनात् नो यू आर टॉकिंग ऑफ टिल नो यू आर टॉकिंग ऑफ प्रकाश टेकिंग इट फॉर ग्रांटेड दैट द फॉल्ट इज ओनली इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ प्रकाश नो यू स्टिल नो नो द फॉल्ट इज इन द आई ओके द फॉल्ट इज इन द आई देयरफॉर आई एम नॉट एबल टू सी You are telling it is not so? That's very good. No. That's what I am telling. The fault is in the I, not in the Jnata. There is either, there is no Prakasha. That means the fault. That is also Prama, Karanam, Pramanam. That is, Prakasha produces knowledge. Therefore, that is also a Karana, instrument for producing. Oh, the fault is not of Prakasha, it is my eyes. Okay.
Swamiji is referring to the intellect indirectly.
No, we will see gradually. Now he has come up to the eyes. Let us see. So, the mistake is in the eyes. Very good. The mistake is in the eyes. But not in Jnata. You are following? The mistake is in the eyes, not in the Jnata. Is not the eye Jnata, Jnaya for you? The Karne Chakshu Viparita Grahana Doshasya Darshana. Viparita Adi Grahanam Tannimittam Va Taivirikattva Dosha Grahitu Chakshuha Samskarena Tavire Apanite Grahitur Adarshana Na Grahitur Dharmo Yatha. See. First the Prakasha was exhausted. Now I am coming to the eyes. The moment you know, hey, there is Prakasha, everything. I have gone to for testing. I am not able to see the board there. Oh, then you have to repair the eye. When you saturate the eyes, then you will be able to see clearly. So from outside he is coming inside, inside. Are you able to see? Finally, what he wants to establish is, in Jnata, there is really nothing. No fault. That's what he is trying to show. Is it clear? No. So now, get it repaired. Get the eyes repaired. Aparita grihitar darshana, grihitar dharmayatha. Therefore, when the eyes are saturated, there is nothing wrong with you. You are able to see it. Only eyes are saturated. तथा सिमिलरली सर्वत्रैव अग्रहण विपरीत संशय प्रत्यास निमित्ताः करणस्यैव जस्ट एज इन दिस एग्जांपल आई हैव टोल्ड बट सर्वत्रैव सर्वत्रैव एवरीवेयर वेयर विल बी द फॉल्ट इट इज ओनली इन द करण Have you understood? Karana Seva. Kasichit Bhavitum Arhati. Some Karana. Na Jnatuha Kshetrajnyasya. There is no fault in Jnata at all. Jnatu
Kshetra ki Jnata Eto Kliyali.
Therefore say gradually why is coming? He is step by step he is showing that Jnata, there is nothing wrong with him. संवेद्यत्वा चेतेषां प्रदीप प्रकाशवत् न ज्ञातृधर्मत्वम् सी samvedyatvaccha. Are you not clearly telling that I am not able to see? I am not able to know? As long as I have not understood, I am saying, or I am not understanding it. I am not understanding it. Are you not telling? Therefore, samvedyatvaccha, you are understanding avidya. See, that I am ignorant, you are knowing. That I am confused, you are knowing. That I am understanding wrongly. How am I understanding wrongly? Are I know, even after death I will be here. But no, I am thinking it for this. I can't help it. I am thinking I am the body. Okay. Therefore, you are understanding all this. Are I know I am different from the body, but I am thinking it is the I am the body. There is something wrong. Don't you say that? Therefore, you are seeing agrahana, you are seeing samshaya grahana, you are seeing also anitha grahana. All the three are exhausted now. Therefore, they are all different from you. Avidya is different from you. Because you are here witnessing it. Samvedyatvaccha tesham pradip prakashvat na jnatra dharmatvam. The moment you start analyzing, are I really don't know. Are you not understanding it? I don't know you are understanding. Therefore, I don't know is jnaya. For you.
It is different from us.
Yes, different from us. Sarvakarna vyoga cha kaivalya sarvadvi avidya didoshvatva anubhyapagmat atmanaham. See, therefore, all the mistakes could only be in the karana. When you have known this, what is it you gain? In that case, in the absence of karana, every karana, will I already become a mukta? See what Bhaskara is establishing now? The fault is invariably only in the karanas, he is telling. So without karana, I am already mukta?
Yes.
You are?
Yes.
Without karana, you are already mukta. Because after having prepared the body, everything, anena jivena atmana anupravishya nama rupe vyakaravani, that is, God has entered here. So he has entered as he is. He has entered as he is. See, the moment he entered, he does not become a fool. He has deliberately entered. Is it not so? Therefore, he is as he is. He had no karana. Now, making use of this karana, he is doing all these things. Is it not so? Therefore, all these doshas, mistakes will only be in the karana. When you are free from karana, you are already Ishvara. Okay. Sarvakarna vyoga cha kaivalya sarvadibhi avidya doshatva anubhyapagamat. Everybody agrees. What? The moment you are free of all karana, then you are mukta. Everybody agrees. You may not be knowing it clearly. It will be explained later. When there are karanas, only you are there. Now you experience yourself. In sushupti, you are free from karana. Is that or is not? Yes. Is there bondage there?
No.
Is it clear or not? Therefore, everybody agrees. No, that fellow, he is not old, he is not dying, he is not taking birth. Therefore, there is nothing like Bandha Moksha for him. Therefore, suppose you say, Yadi Kshetrajnasya Agnishnavat Svodharmaha, Tatha Nakadashadabhitena Vyogasyat. Remember, suppose avidya is the inherent dosha of Kshetrajna. It is built into him, avidya. Suppose you say that, you can never get rid of it. If you say you can never get rid of it, then all the shastras you will have to throw into the sea. Because they are preaching exactly that. You give up your avidya, know it. Durmete uparite vishuchi vidyacha vidyacheti. All the humans are teaching. Therefore, everything becomes meaningless. Therefore, never say that it is Swadharma of Kshetrajna. It is not his inherent nature. If you say it is in his inherent nature, he can never get rid of it. Are you following? Na kadachanitainva yogasya. Avikirasya vyomavat sarvatasya amurtasya atmanaha kyanishit sanyoga avyoga anupatte siddham kshetrajnasya nityameva ishvaratvam anatvam nirgunatvati vishvarochanachya. See. Now, when you are free from all the karanas, whenever you make this statement, just think of Sushupti. When you are free from all the karanas, avikriya, the one who is there remaining in Sushupti is avikriya. What is avikriya? You can't tamper with him. Are you following or not? When I am sitting in the eyes, you can tamper with the eye. Is it right? When my thinking is all something wrong, then you may give some tablets or something like that to saturate the neuronal firings. Okay. Therefore, this is all vikriya. That is, they can be tampered with. Whereas in Sushupti, it is avikriya. You can't tamper with him. Can you rub him like this? It's avikriya. Vyomavat. He is spread all over. Sarvagatasya. Amurtasya. That is, he has no specific shapes or anything. Amurtasya. Atmanaha. Kyanchit sanyoga vyoga anupatte hai. How can he get attached to the body? See, take for instance, Akasha is there. Okay. Now, suppose there is water. You have put water in a tub. When I get into it, the water will flow out. Have you understood now? No, when people are coming and going, nothing is happening in Akasha. What is the difference? The body and the water, they will stick to each other. Whereas Akasha is not sticking to the bodies. Is it clear? It is Amurta. Okay. Therefore, Vyomavat, Sarvagata. Therefore, Kshetrajna is like that. He is untouched. Therefore, Sanyoga with the body is impossible. adhyasa is impossible, actually. If you are having association with the body, it is only due to avidya. And that avidya is only a karana dharma.
Karana dharma.
Again and again, remember, it is clearly, see, this sentence is very clearly told. Samskarana, Dosha, Grihita Chakshu Samskarana Apatayipteti, Grihita Darshana, Tannimitam Karane Chakshushi. It is invariably in the Karanas, not in you. Take this very clear-cut example. Very clear-cut example is, I am able to see avidya. I am able to see samshayagrahana, agrahana. I am not understanding anything about what you are telling. Are you not telling me? There is something really remarkable. If you go on analyzing. Okay. You see, for instance, very clearly. See, in a class, teacher will be sitting and he will be looking at the people. He will say, yeah, you have not understood properly. That's it. So when he says, you have not understood properly, this teacher is superior to the student. That his understanding is also he is knowing, not understanding also he is knowing. This is our common experience, is it not so? No, see anybody. Suppose he doesn't understand, he knows he doesn't understand. Therefore, who is this sitting inside who is certifying it? Are you following? Someone is telling, you have not understood. Therefore, obviously, he must be very superior to me. Is it clear? What does psychology say? Bhaiji, what does psychology say?
That is why she has come here. Find the answers.
Therefore, see, this extraordinary peculiar. All of you, see, when you are studying Shankar Bhashya, I appeal to you. See, it's simply terrible. Bhashyakara. Are there something inside? I say, you are, for instance, knowing that you are stupid. Okay. One who is knowing that you are stupid is not stupid. When you say you are stupid, you are stupid.
Yes.
The one who is telling that he is stupid, is stupid. But one who is knowing that he is stupid, is not stupid. Is that stupid? Is it clear?
Knowing as such will not happen. Kshetrajna?
See, is not Kshetrajna the one who is knowing everything?
He is the knower, but activity of knowing.
Nama, when the activity is there, let him know through the manas. That is not an objection. But the one who is telling it is superior because this mind is stupid. This mind is stupid. It is understanding wrongly. But who certifies that it is understanding wrongly?
That's clear that there's a higher level. But it is Kshetrajna.
Who is Kshetrajna? Tell me.
Because it can be a part of the...
No, who is Kshetrajna? Tell me. Who is Kshetrajna?
Myself.
Huh?
Myself.
Who are you? That is why I... Let me make you one statement. See, please understand clearly. The moment you say Kshetrajna, everybody is understanding, Mahama, Pandits also are also understanding only like this. Okay? It's not only your difficulty. Therefore, I will go through every sentence to show how much of analysis Bhashyakara has done. When he shows, your Kshetrajna is not stupid. He is Ishvara. Okay? Therefore, go step by step. That's why I'm doing. He started with Prakasha, then came inside to the eyes, then now coming to the mind. Now finally he's telling, he is certifying. All of you should know this. You connect with everything. Only then you will be able to understand. Oh, sarvasya chaham mrita sannivishta matta smritir jnanam apohanancha. I am sitting in the hearts of everybody, and it is due to me that people understand, and people remember what they understand, and people forget what they understand. It is due to me, he says. Okay. No, forget about Bhagavan's statement. You see yourself. Are you not understanding that you have understood? Are you not understanding that you have misunderstood? Are you not understanding that you have not understood? Are you not understanding that you have forgotten? Who is it that is certifying this? Have you understood? Therefore, this is when it says Prajnanam Brahma, Tattvamasi and all that. This statement is too profound. Yes. Don't try to monkey with it. Too statement, too powerful. Okay. In fact, Carl Jung is a very great psychologist. Okay. So, he says, in one place he has written, Upanishads say that there is one inside deeply as Sakshi, unaffected. There is nothing logically wrong here. Logically it is very correct. We don't find anything illogical here. But what exactly it is, I am not able to know. Okay. Then he also has made a statement. But I also know that none of these people who come here for giving lectures on Upanishads can tell me. He has told that also. Because now what he has to understand is this. It is not something to try to understand. You can't understand it. Top people, scientists, commit this mistake. Okay, neuronal firings are there. Consciousness is concealed here. I will locate it. Consciousness is that by which you want to search, by which you want to understand. How can you understand that? You can't sit on your own shoulders. And so, therefore, like this Sakshi is there. Now, Kshetrajnasya Nityamev Ishwaratvam. Therefore, he has to be Nitya, Ishvara. I think you are following? Therefore, what is it that has been pointed out? Remember this clearly. Kshetrajna means one who is seeing everything. In fact, seeing everything means everything. Why did I say? Because there is nothing else which exists but not, cannot be seen. There everything is seen by. By seen, don't think that it is like this. It is grasped. For instance, I know that I have not understood. Okay. Take for instance top scientists. First they will realize some truth for which there is no proof. First they will understand the truth and then supply the proof. And we ordinary people, through the proof we understand that. We are ordinary people. The great scientist, without proof he understood and he supplied the proof. He supplied the proof so that poor people like us can understand. Otherwise, to see the truth, proof is not necessary. It is by its own nature. Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
You know many, many examples. For instance, Ramanujan. Oh, here it's a bizarre, horrible looking one series. It will be like this. They say, this is equal to, if you go up to infinity, it is 1/π, you will say. How do you know it? I don't know, Mahalakshmi told me in the dreams. He has not given proof for it. Afterwards, for 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, they find struggle and they have got the proof. Okay, how did it happen? Therefore, what Ramanujan told is actually correct. Mahalakshmi gave it in his dreams. That's it. Why I'm telling this is for the following reason. When you understand, realize that it is because of his grace that you have understood. Are you following me? See, depending on my effort to understand, he blesses me. My role is only to struggle, not to get the fruit. The fruit he gives.
Sometimes we get an intuition and we feel we must do this.
It'll be wrong.
Why.
It'll be wrong.
No, not that.
It'll be right.
It will be right.
Yeah.
And can we say that this is the Sakshi or Kshitrakya guiding us somehow?
See, what I'm telling is the following. When you have got it, the question is, how did you get it? You don't know. The reason is he has graced it. That is all. For that to understand Shastra is necessary. That is why he says, Sarvasya chaham ursannivishta matta smritir jnanapohanancha. Right? Now see. Then he will raise another issue. Nanu evam samsara samsaritva bhave shastra adakhyadi dosha syad iti chet na sarvaihi abhyapagamat. You have told. No. That there is no samsara at all. Samsara is there only due to ignorance. You have told that. So, samsara, samsaritva, bhava hi nahi hai. There is nothing like that. So, actually, remember this word. When actually there is no samsara, samsari at all, Shastra is artha. Please use this. Shastra is there. Shastra, acts only when there is something to be achieved. You do this karma, know this, do this, do this. It will tell. And accordingly, if I act, I will be profited. Okay. No, you are not telling that samsaritobhava is really existing. Not all existing. You are telling. It is not at all really existing. Then Shastra is meaningless. Have you understood or not?
Because Shastra is required to understand that. And now we have understood, so Shastra.
No, see. Samsara is there. No. Whether this samsara is there really or not, inherently or not, that is the question. Suppose it is there inherently, then Shastra is there, it will remove it. Okay. No, it is not all there, it is due to ignorance. If you say, actually, in truth, there is no samsara. If you say, then Shastra is meaningless. Okay. So, then he says, first, see, Shastra becomes anartha, meaningless, is it not so? Shastra becomes meaningless for everybody who accepts moksha. Anybody who accepts moksha, for him Shastra is anartha, meaningless. See how? Sarvairabhyapagamato. Sarvairhi atmavadibhi abhyapagamato abhyapagato dosha na ekena parihartavyo bhavati. Everybody accepts that Shastra is not all necessary afterwards. Afterwards means what? In mukti dasha. Okay. Katham abhyapagata iti muktatmanam samsara samsaritva vyavahara abhava sarvaireva atmavadi vishyate. Anybody who talks of moksha certainly agrees that samsara samsaritva vyavahara abhava. Nobody who accepts moksha says there is samsara still. Moksha itself means complete absence of samsara. Therefore, that is also, we are also telling. What is moksha? Samsara, sabhava. Nobody says for muktatma also there is some samsara. Nobody says it. Yatesham shastra anthakyati dosha praptahi. For them there is no shastra anthakyati dosha. They will also be having the same dosha. Tathanaha kshatrajnanam ishvarekatvesi shastra anthakyam bhavato. In other words, when moksha, there is no shastra, it is meaningless. Bhavato. Let it be meaningless. Know this. Shastra itself tells this. In moksha dasha, what happens is, tatra vedaha avedaha bhavanti. Veda becomes aveda. Veda loses its existence. Are you following? Veda is actually a karya of Brahman. In Brahman there is no karya. Is it clear? Therefore, in moksha, there is no shastra. Shastra consists of dharma, adharma. This is adharma, don't do. This is dharma, do. Or, know this, it'll be benefit you. If you know this, you will be losing. There is neither getting nor getting rid of in moksha. There is nothing. What is there? Whenever you hear such statements and if it confuses you, think of Sushupti. It is a sort of one very powerful weapon. Suppose you are talking of Brahman, you didn't understand. Veda, Aveda, what does it mean? There you think of it. There is no Veda, there is no Aveda, there is no Dharma, there is no Adharma. A downright murderer and a scoundrel sleeps. A rishi sleeps. Sleep, both are same. Neither this fellow nor that fellow. Okay. Shastana kem bhavato? Avidya vishesha arthavattvam. But Shastra does not become anartha when? As long as there is avidya. Therefore, to remove avidya, Shastra is necessary. It is Shastra which gives prakasha.
To remove the ignorance,
Shastra is necessary. That is why we should go on learning it, thinking about it, get all the doubts clarified. Shrotavyaha, mantavyaha. And then, if you simply ruminate, over, it is over. Avidya vishesha arthavatvam. Yathadvaitinam sarvesham bandhavasthayam eva shastradhyarthavattvam namuktavasthayam. Even dvaitis will also agree in mukti. Therefore, in bandhavastha there is shastra. In muktavastha there is no shastra. Let it be like that. Stop it. Bola.
Namami Bhagavat Padam Shankaram Rupa Shankaram Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Padarayanam Sutra Bhashya Kritau Vande Bhagavantau Punam Punam Ishvaro Guru Ratneti Murti Bede Bhagine Yomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah.